R is an open source language and environment for statistical computing and graphics. Oracle Big Data Manager provides a Zeppelin notebook environment that lets you use Spark R against a variety of big data and relational data sources, including Impala tables, R data frames, Spark data frames, Oracle database, Hdfs, and Hive tables. Oracle R Advanced Analytics for Hadoop, or ORA, is required when interacting with both Oracle database and supported big data formats in a single R session. We're going to analyze data in the open source Iris dataset. This dataset is commonly used to teach analytic and data visualization techniques in R. It contains three species, Setosa, Virginica, and Versicolor, and has four features measured for each sample. For example, here's a frequency histogram of the sepal length and sepal width for each of the plant species. So we've stored a copy of the Iris dataset in each of the supported big data storage formats to show how each input format is accessed by R using Oracle Big Data Manager. To begin, we load the Oracle R Advanced Analytics for Hadoop packages using the core ORCH Java library. Although not required, we create a custom function named ZepShow. This function lets us easily identify each of the supported big data formats for the Iris dataset. So let's walk through the function definition. Initially, the function verifies whether or not the ORCH packages are loaded. If so, the first input format check is made to see if it's a Spark data frame. In this code segment, a random sample of the data is generated and the data is returned. Now, if the input is not a Spark data frame, the function continues on to identify the input format. So we scroll down to view code segments for the other supported input formats. If the input data is HDFS, we simply construct a display format for the dataset and return the data. If the input format is Hive, we traverse the data, create a Hive view with a random sample of the data, and return the results. Otherwise, we continue to check for additional input formats. If the input is an Impala table, we pull the data, format it, and return the dataset. If the input is an R data frame, the dataset is traversed, a random sample is generated, and the results are returned. Now, if not, none of the supported input formats have been used, and an invalid input error is returned stating that case. At the end of the ZepShow function, a final else clause handles the case that the ORCH libraries are not loaded. In this case, only R data frames can be used as input. So, the data frame is traversed, formatted for display, and the data set is returned. Otherwise, an invalid input error is returned stating that the ORCH library is not loaded and the input format is not an R data frame. Now, let's look at the Zeppelin Notebook data visualization features. The notebook provides built-in tools that let you view your analytic results in these formats: table, bar chart, pie chart, area chart, line chart, and scatter chart. In addition, you can format the output in a variety of ways using the settings option. So, here is the graphical output of the Iris dataset from a local R data frame using the ZepShow function. We have run a random sample of the data and select a scatter chart graph for visualization purposes. You can select any of the other display types from the graphical output toolbar at any time. As mentioned, you can modify the layout of any graph by clicking the settings option. For a scatter chart, you can select fields for the x-axis, y-axis, group, and size options. You can also select any data point to view numeric details. Here, we select a Setosa species data point that shows its sepal length and width. Next, we show an example of connecting to Hive from R using Aura. First, we connect to a specified Hive host with the ORECONNECT function. Then, we check to see if the iris_hive table exists. If not, we push the iris data frame to Hive as a table. Then, we show the available tables in the Hive repository with the ORELS function, and we see that the iris_hive table is there. Now, using the ZepShow function, we view a bar graph of a random sample of data in the iris_hive table. Here, the results include 10 rows, but the random sample is generated from the entire data set. So, if the table has 1,000,000 rows, we get the same distribution with our 10 rows as is found in the entire 1,000,000-row source. In this example, we use Aura to connect to Impala from R, using the same ORECONNECT function. And, as before, we ensure that the desired Impala table exists for our analysis. Then, we use ZepShow to view a stacked bar graph of data from the iris_impala table. In this case, the Impala input is running a top-n records result, rather than a random sample that we used in the last example. Next, we view graphical output from an HDFS file. In this case, we simply push the local R iris data frame from memory to a temporary HDFS file, which is mapped as an Aura DFS ID. Then, we use ZepShow to view a pie graph of the data. Here, we're only running a top-n result, since HDFS doesn't have any analytic capabilities such as randomizing. As with any graphical output, click a data point to view its supporting data. In this case, we see a sum of the Setosa sepal length values. And if you want to view the underlying input data for any graph, simply click the Table tool in the Display Options menu. You now know how to execute statistical analysis and visualize the results with R against a variety of big data input sources by using Oracle Big Data Manager's Zeppelin Notebook. Learn more at cloud.oracle.com/bigdata.